Biomes are large geographical areas with distinct fauna and flora which are adapted to that particular environment. A region's climate and geography determines what type of biome can exist there. Biomes are divided into aquatic and terrestrial biomes. Aquatic biomes are those which are water-based, such as the seagrass meadows in Shark Bay, Western Australia, or these kelp forests on the mid-north coast of New South Wales. Terrestrial biomes are those based on land. Not all scientists classify biomes in the same way. Many school textbooks use five broad terrestrial biome categories, such as forests, grasslands, tundra, deserts, and marine. Others, such as the World Wildlife Fund for Nature, divide the Earth into 14 different biomes, as can be seen here on this map. On maps, the boundaries between biomes are arbitrary and appear abrupt, but in reality, there are transition zones between biomes where animals and plants from neighbouring biomes overlap. Australia, with an area of over 7 million square kilometres and spanning 33 degrees of latitude, has a large range of climate zones. Northern Australia is characterised by a warm tropical climate with a dry season and a wet season. The southern part of Australia has a cooler temperate climate and can even experience snow. Of the Earth's continents, Australia has the lowest average elevation, it is the flattest, and is the second driest. With such a range of climate zones, it is no surprise that there are also many types of biome in Australia. Sclerophyll forests represent the classic Australian vegetation type. These eucalypt-dominated forests have flora with hard, short, and often spiky leaves. There are two main subtypes of sclerophyll forest. Dry sclerophyll forests are typically found in areas with low rainfall and low nutrient soils. These forests are dominated by short to medium-sized eucalypts and have an understory of plants such as banksias and wattles. They have an open canopy, which means more light reaches the forest floor in some places. Dry sclerophyll forests are well adapted, so they regenerate after bushfires. Some of Australia's most well-known mammal species can call these forests home, including the koala and the eastern grey kangaroo, as well as numerous species of bird and reptile. Wet sclerophyll forests occur on moderately fertile soils in areas of high rainfall and are characterised by tall eucalypts that grow up to 60 metres, such as these nationally significant coastal blackbutt trees seen here. They have a canopy that shelters an understory of shrubs, ferns and herbs. Many rainforest species may also be found in the understory of these wet sclerophyll forests. In New South Wales, this type of forest is located in the Great Dividing Range and on the eastern side of the escarpment. Many animals are more common in these forests due to its diverse abundance of food resources. Insectivorous birds will feed on the abundance of insects and spiders. Since Australia is the driest inhabited continent on Earth, rainforests account for only 0.5% of Australia's land area. The wetter areas east of the Great Dividing Range is where most rainforest is found, with tropical and subtropical rainforest types in Queensland and northern New South Wales. Temperate rainforest types can be found in southeastern Australia and in western Tasmania. Rainforests are characterised by dense vegetation that depends on high rainfall and have big trees with a canopy that shuts out most sunlight and shade-tolerant plants that grow in the lower layers. Rainforests are an important biome for biodiversity as they have almost half of Australia's plant families and a third of Australia's bird and mammal species. Plus, an abundant diversity of reptiles and insects. Eucalypt woodlands have fewer and shorter trees with an understory of grasses and shrubs. They form a transitional zone between the forested regions with higher rainfall near the coast and the spinifex grasslands of the arid interior. There are significant woodlands in northern Australia, west of the Great Dividing Range in eastern Australia, and the Great Western Woodlands of Western Australia. Across the continent, eucalypt woodlands have been heavily cleared for agriculture. Only fragments of woodland remain, typically only by creeks, roadsides, and around rocky outcrops. The grassland biome is an ecological community dominated by grasses with no or only sparse numbers of trees and shrubs. Northern Australia is characterised by tropical savanna grassland. This is because the land does not receive enough rainfall in these regions. The tropical climate has a wet season and a dry season. Fires are common in the dry season. Temperate grasslands are located between the woodlands and the arid interior of Australia, in large parts of southeastern Australia, as well as the vast Nullarbor Plain in the southwest. Much of this environment has been converted to sheep and wheat agriculture. Temperate grasslands have a greater variation in temperature than tropical grasslands and have a wider variety of species living there. Marsupials such as kangaroos are the dominant animals of the grasslands. 70% of mainland Australia is arid or semi-arid desert. These regions are characterised by low precipitation and extreme temperatures, where daytime temperatures can reach over 45 degrees Celsius, followed by very cold nights due to the lack of cloud cover. Due to the seasonal availability of water, rivers in these regions are said to be ephemeral, which means they are dry for much of the year. Some deserts have stony or sandy surfaces, but other deserts have vast grasslands containing hummocky-looking spinifex grass, shrubs such as the saltbush, and trees such as the ghost gum. In the spinifex grasslands, ants and termites are the dominant insects. Despite the harsh environmental conditions, deserts support a rich variety of plants and wildlife. Australia's deserts contain the richest reptile communities in the world. Most of Australia is low-lying compared to the other landmasses on this planet, but there is a region of montane grasslands and shrublands in the Snowy Mountains, which cover parts of New South Wales, Victoria, and the Australian Capital Territory. Due to colder temperatures at higher altitudes, the higher parts of the Snowy Mountains are too cold for trees to grow. Around 1300 metres, snow gums give way to alpine plant communities consisting of heathland, alpine grasses, herb fields, and bogs.